My name is Adrian David. I was a research intern at OIST in 2014 and a PhD student between 2015 and 2020. I came to OIST with an interest in theoretical physics and a background in mathematics, and I worked on problems of quantum gravity in the mathematical and theoretical physics unit and then quantum gravity unit. Throughout my time at OIST, I became very involved in the community. I was involved with the student council for 4 years and I was chair of student council in 2019. And throughout that process, I really wanted to make OIST a better place for everyone and kind of make research and education and science accessible to a broad number of people. And that's what led me to work in the education sector. Currently, I work for an educational startup that's helping high school students who want to apply to university abroad by pairing them with a mentor who has studied the same subject or at the same universities that the student wants to, by guiding them through the whole application process. So for me, doing a PhD at OIST was the right decision for 3 reasons. Number one, the breadth of science that I was exposed to, which is unlike any other place. Number two, the people. I met some extraordinary people from all over the world, which I'm very grateful for. And number three, it was really exciting to be part of a young university and being involved in the whole process of setting it up. So something I always tell people before they start a PhD is how important the unit that you join is. Yes, it's very important to be passionate about the project that you're about to embark on, but it is as important to find the right supervisor and the right community for you. So I think the lowest point of my PhD came about halfway through the program, just after my proposal exam, when I wasn't sure if I was on the right academic path and whether my passions for the subject would be enough to carry me through. So after finishing my PhD, especially after like having to write my PhD thesis during the first part of the pandemic, I decided to take some time off. So I went back home to Romania for 8 months. To decompress after the whole journey. And during that time, this opportunity arose for me to work in an educational startup in Bucharest. And I was like, why not? Let's give it a go. So I currently live in Bucharest and I'm head of operations at Upgrade Education, which is a startup that works in the education sector. My role itself is very broad. It being a startup, that means that there's a lot of various roles to fill. And basically I just ensure that the daily operations of the company run smoothly, but I'm also like in charge with various projects to make sure that the company grows in a scalable way. For example, one of the things that I do, I interview mentors, like new mentors, which involve sort of discussing with them ideas about tutoring and mentoring and sort of making sure that they're a right fit for our students. The path it took me to get here was not at all predictable. This is not what I thought I would be doing. This is not what I had planned that I would be doing. In fact, even the role itself was not advertised per se. Initially, I got in touch with them for a different role, and it was after some discussion that they decided to offer me this position in the operations team. So there's two hobbies I picked up at OIST, one of them being yoga and the other one being ballet. And both of them I started because there were people, students actually at OIST, who were offering yoga and ballet classes. And even though I had been dancing my whole life, this was the first time I met such a structured dance form. But it was very exciting for me to have this as a weekly practice to kind of like get me out of my head a bit and more into my body. So I think my tip for anyone in the PhD program or graduating for the PhD program is to be patient with yourself and take the time you need to figure things out. No matter how chaotic things are, no matter the external pressures that you might face, I think it's really important that you allow yourself to sit down and really figure out what it is that you want to do. And plans might change, that's perfectly fine. And so allow yourself the time to do that.